Hello, my name is Marjorie de Clare.
Hi, I'm Alberto Noriega Crespo.
Hi, my name is Paul Scowen.
Hello, I am Jesus Toala.
So the Eagle Nebula is a very big star-forming region, and it is full of dust and gas, and in these clouds, stars are continuously being formed.
So triggered star formation is a mechanism by which star formation self-propagates across a galaxy. The idea is that you make a series of stars in one particular location. That causes this ionized cavity that we recognize as a nebula, of which the Eagle Nebula is a good example. The ionizing radiation that comes off those central stars blows a bubble. That's really what the cavity of a nebula is. And as that bubble grows, it collapses and compresses the material outside the wall of that cavity. And the material there, the gas and dust, is then compressed and collapses under gravity to form a second generation of stars and planets.
One of the features that one see at optical wavelengths in the large view is that really the dust is present and forms the shape of an eagle in the outer part, and it's illuminated by the newborn stars that some of them are very hot.
In the near infrared, you're seeing the stars themselves, you're seeing heat of the light that's being emitted by them, and you're seeing where those stars are relative to the walls of the nebula.
So in the infrared image, what we can see is that the dust emits light, and depending on the temperature of the dust particles, it will emit at shorter infrared wavelengths or longer infrared wavelengths.
So people notice, in particular when you go a longer wavelength, is that you don't see as many sources. The stars themselves have a shape of their emission. In particular, when they're very young, they're very blue. And so they essentially disappear because essentially they are not emitting. You get to see some other sources, and indeed, probably many of the sources are cooler, older, and may not belong to the closet itself.
In the X-rays, we see the hottest contribution of the gas, which is produced by the stellar winds from the most massive stars in the region. My favorite thing about the Eagle Nebula is the fact that we can use multi-instrument observations to characterize the origins of stars. Multi-wavelength observations help us peer into a phenomenon with different glasses, in this case, stellar nurseries. The Pillars of Creation is a collection of filaments that are located at the heart of the Eagle Nebula. This was formed as a result of the impact of the most massive stars in the nebula. These stars have winds and strong UV light that evaporates the initial configuration of the nebula from which they were born. As a result, the pillars point towards the location of these massive stars.
The name creation comes from the fact that there are lots and lots of stars being formed continuously out of the dust and gas clouds. And so this is very interesting because when we study this image, we can learn a lot about how stars are being formed in these clouds.
In the Hubble images themselves, we don't penetrate the columns, right? We don't see the stars. We see the surrounding and we see them illuminated. Perhaps some of the edges, we can see some of the protostars. Infrared images, like the ones from JWST, we begin to see not only the dust, but also we can see the protostars. We can see through some of the columns, and we can see where they are being born.
In the MIRI images, this filter was chosen specifically to probe a particle that we call polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. These specific dust particles will emit light, and that's why you can see that parts of these dust clouds are now shining.
In the X-ray, you're going to see a rather different story. Most of the nebulosity that you see in the visible and in the infrared disappears altogether. And all you see is the bright emission coming from those few massive stars kicking out all of the radiation that lights up the nebula in the visible and the infrared. But in the X-ray, all you see is the stars, and that's pretty much it.
What strikes me the most of the James Webb images is the details. There is no comparison with previous infrared missions in terms of sharpness and fine detail disclosed by the James Webb Space Telescope.
Have you ever wanted to make your own astronomy image?
Tell us about the colors you choose.
Were they scientific, artistic, or both?
We want to see what you've done.